I will read Psalms 91. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. Verse 2. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress. My God, in Him will I trust. Verse 3. Surely He shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. Chapter 4. He shall cover thee with His feathers, and under His wings shalt thou trust. His truth shall be thy shield and buckler. Chapter 5. Thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by night, nor for the arrow that flieth by day. Verse 6. Nor for the pestilence that walketh in darkness, nor for the destruction that wasteth at noonday. Verse 7. 1,000 shall fall at thy side, and 10,000 at thy right hand, but it shall not come nigh thee. Verse 8. Only with thine eyes shalt thou behold and see the reward of the wicked. Verse 9. Because thou hast made the Lord, which is my refuge, even the Most High, thy habitation. Verse 10. There shall no evil befall thee, neither shall any plague come nigh thy dwelling. Verse 11. For He shall give His angels charge over thee, to keep thee in all thy ways. Verse 12. They shall bear thee up in their hands, lest thou dash thy foot against a stone. Verse 13. Thou shalt tread upon the lion and adder, the young lion and the dragon shalt thou trample underfoot. Verse 14. Because He hath set His love upon me, therefore will I deliver him. I will set him on high, because he hath known my name. Verse 15. He shall call upon me, and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. Verse 16. With long life will I satisfy him, and shew him my salvation. Verse 16. Now I read Psalm 51. Have mercy upon me, O God, according to thy loving kindness, according unto the multitude of thy tender mercies, blot out my transgressions. Verse 2. Wash me thoroughly from mine iniquity, and cleanse me from my sin. Verse 3. For I acknowledge my transgressions, and my sin is ever before me. Verse 4. Against thee only have I sinned, and done this evil in thy sight, that thou mightest be justified when thou speakest, and be clear when thou judgest. Verse 5. Behold, I was shapen in iniquity, and in sin did my mother conceive me. Verse 6. Behold, thou desirest truth in the inward parts, and in the hidden part thou shalt make me to know wisdom. Verse 7. Purge me with hyssop, and I shall be clean. Wash me, and I shall be whiter than snow. Verse 8. Make me to hear joy and gladness, that the bones which thou hast broken may rejoice. Verse 9. Hide thy face from my sins, and blot out all mine iniquities. Verse 10. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Verse 11. Cast me not away from thy presence, and take not thy Holy Spirit from me. Verse 12. Restore unto me the joy of thy salvation, and uphold me with thy free spirit. Verse 13. Then will I teach transgressors thy ways, and sinners shall be converted unto thee. Verse 14. Deliver me from blood guiltiness, O God, thou God of my salvation, and my tongue shall sing aloud of thy righteousness. Verse 15. O Lord, open thou my lips, and my mouth shall shew forth thy praise. Verse 16. For thou desirest not sacrifice, else would I give it. Thou delightest not in burnt offering. Verse 17. The sacrifices of God are a broken spirit, a broken and a contrite heart, O God, thou wilt not despise. Verse 18. Do good in thy good pleasure unto Zion. Build thou the walls of Jerusalem. Verse 19. Then shalt thou be pleased with the sacrifices of righteousness, with burnt offering and whole burnt offering. Then shall they offer bullocks upon thine altar. Hanggang dito na lang po muna. Kung lalobin ng Panginoon, magawa pa ng maraming video. Salamat sa Diyos Ama na kay Kristo Jesus. Lahat po ng blessing, lahat ng honor, lahat ng glory, lahat ng power ay sa Diyos Ama at sa Panginoong Jesus Kristo lamang. Magpasawalang hanggan. Siya nawa. Amen.